Welcome to another members question from the recruiting gym. Every week we get asked tens of questions by our members on how can they grow their recruitment businesses. And today I'm going to tackle a question that I can't believe I'm going to try and resolve in 4 minutes, because I'm going to answer the question, how do I serve my clients better? Now, why is serving your clients better such a difficult question to ask? Well, it just really depends. It's such a massive topic. But I guess what I take from the question is the fact that most recruiters want to deliver a better service to their clients. Why do they want to do that? Well, the easiest way to scale in recruitment is not to win new business, it's actually to get repeat business from existing clients. That way, not only when you've got jobs coming in, are they easier to fill because you better know the client, it's easier to hire someone else to work with that existing client and then free you up to go and win new business. The true way to absolutely explode in recruitment business, though, is not only be fantastic at retaining and expanding clients, but also being really consistent in winning clients. But back to the question at hand, how do we serve our clients better? So when I thought about this question, I knew there was no definitive answer, but the answer actually isn't specific to one industry or one sector. It comes down to your knowledge of individual customers and what they like and don't like. About 10 years ago, I used to go over to Germany two or three times a year for a weekend, and I'd get put in a like this warehouse, and there'd be prototype cars from Audi and Seat and VW. And the questions they would ask you were like, what do you think about the door handle? What do you think about the shape of the grill? And they would give you four different grill shapes. They might ask you what you thought about the air nozzle thing on the Audi. It's silver and gold and that sort of stuff. And I was always struck by, well, this is a lot of detail to be going into when you want to build a car. And then I asked the guys that were running it, and they went, well, to put a car on the road, you're looking at £2 or 3 billion. You know, I want to know I'm going to get it right. But yet recruiters are stuck in the mindset where their service is measured by the candidate that they present. Where actually serving your customers is not just about the candidate you present, it's how the experience of recruitment actually feels. And so the question I'm going to ask you is, how well do you genuinely know what your clients want and don't want from a recruitment service? Some want lots of CVs, some want very few. Some want a fast recruitment process, some want slow. Some want to interview on your site, some want discretion. It's tailored to that individual, and the more tailored you are in your approach, the greater the likelihood is they're going to feel that you're serving them better than any other recruiter. And so there's three or four questions that I get every recruiter to ask their clients. And the reason I do this is it starts the ball rolling of really understanding what individual clients want rather than you thinking you know what they want. And so the first one is, what do you want from a recruitment service when you use an agency? What do you want? You'd be amazed what they'll actually come up with. The next thing you've got to ask, what frustrates you about working with recruiters and recruiting as a whole? What is it you enjoy about the process? What is it you not enjoy about the recruitment process? The third one is, what changes and challenges do you have in your business at the moment? And the question that builds on that is, and what could I do to help that? How would salary benchmarking help? How would advice on how to retain your best staff help? Serving your clients better isn't just about being there when you've got money to earn. It's about being there through the good times and bad. And so if your client is struggling with performance, it may be you just provide them with insight on how to retain their best staff through change. If they're making redundancies, you might be able to find some articles or some thought leadership around how to manage redundancy situations. Remember, the key for them to feel like you're serving them better is that they believe you're interested in their well-being, irrespective of whether you've got money to pay them this month. And so if you can start focusing on understanding your customer better and serving them when they're recruiting and not recruiting, hopefully you'll move that little bit closer to being the first person they call when they do have a vacancy. Please join us in the gym, ask us some questions, and we'll always answer online. And we may even do a video for you. So we'll look forward to seeing you soon.